also Kosovo member countries, distinguished ambassadors and heads of delegations, dear delegates and participants, invited guests and members of the media, good morning to all of you. It's my pleasure to deliver the opening speech of this third extraordinary congress. The first extraordinary congress was held in Bern, in Switzerland in 1900, and after more than 100 years, the second one was held only last year in Addis Ababa. Now, one short year later, we are holding our third extraordinary congress. These congresses, held in short succession, affirmed the role and relevance of this organization and reflect the pace of business today. Business can no longer wait. The model of holding quadrennial congress is for all decision making has not always shown itself to be supple to get the demands of the 21st century. Recent times have highlighted the Union's need to move quickly to solve the many challenges of the Union and to grasp its numerous opportunities. Ladies and gentlemen, I think I can say without risk of embellishment that this is one of the most important meetings in the Universal Postal Union's 145 years history. We have come together here in Geneva to decide on one question, and one question only, the issue of remuneration rates for the UPU. Before going further, let me say that over the years, since the introduction of the remuneration system at our World Postal Congress in Tokyo in 1969, we have recognized the system is not fit for purpose, but could not be fixed overnight. Over the long years, member countries have striven at successive congresses to refine and improve the rates to reflect the prevailing business trends and models. In Istanbul in 2016, I have thought a consensus had been found, as well as an acceptable timetable for introducing fairer rates. It is therefore regrettable that the new rates could not come soon enough to prevent the necessity of holding this extraordinary congress. I should add that I have a deep respect for this union and the sovereign right of the member countries to express their views and reach sensible solutions, no matter how difficult the terrain or uncomfortable the subject is. The UPU's purpose has always been to create the forum, invite member countries, and encourage the necessary discussions to transform and empower our industry. I also feel, however, a firm sense of duty as a Director General of the Universal Postal Union to speak out on behalf of the integrity of the international postal network. The Universal Postal Union, our union, is powered by the Universal Service Obligation, the duty to ensure that everyone on this planet has access to international mail. Allow me to quote from the scope and objectives of the constitutions of the Universal Postal Union that came into force in 1875. When it first came into force, I quote, "The countries adopting this constitution shall comprise, under the title of the Universal Postal Union, a single postal territory for the reciprocal exchange of letterpost items. Freedom of transit shall be guaranteed throughout the entire territory of the Union." End of quote. And again I quote, "The aim of the Union shall be to secure the organization and improvement of the postal services and to promote in this sphere the development of international collaboration." End of quote. This position is true today as it was in 1875. And for the 145 years, the UPU has upheld the following phrases: single postal territory, freedom of transit guaranteed throughout the entire territory, or the development of international collaboration. I choose these words to remind us of the very reason for our existence as a union. Our meeting today is about the postal remuneration rates, but it's also about all of us choosing the right path for our union. The right path to protecting the integrity of the Universal Service Obligation. The right path for all member countries and their sustained postal development. And the right path to prosperity for this industry. I believe we are at a crossroad. where choices made and verdicts weighed can set the course for the rest of this century. As with all such paths, once decided, the Union may never be able to retrace its steps. The first step along this path will inevitably lead to the next, until the road taken becomes the only road. I say to you that the decisions taken by you must be the correct ones to ensure we stand together to bring the necessary changes to this industry. Changes that leverage the past, but deliver a better future for all of us. Our overarching ambition is to uphold one world, one postal network. Ladies and gentlemen, the Universal Postal Union has been described as many things: a forum, a platform, a network, and a community. But I want to add one more word to this list: an outlier with a concrete vision for this industry's success. For much of the 145 years, the Universal Postal Union has been a share leader for the transformation and renewal throughout the industry, a voice of digitalization, e-commerce, and financial services. And as we move forward to the future, I wish to inform you that we have formulated a roadmap that will keep this union in tune with the industry and general business trends. Thanks to your contribution, we have developed UPU's Postal Vision 2030 that encapsulates the future of the union and the business of the industry. In this regard, we have identified four key areas that need to be addressed for the future development of the post, namely to encourage governments to increase funding in the postal development for their respective countries. Number two, to urge regulators to harmonize their tools to enable uptake of new services and the new platforms. Three, to urge postal operators to address their performance and ensure that they compete favorably in the increasingly open market. And finally, but very important, is to seek integration of all players in the international postal sector. The vision has been tested, road tested, and will hopefully form the Abidjan 2020 strategy, and going on to catalyze this industry. But for real success, we must cooperate, and we must coordinate, and we must unite. Ladies and gentlemen, reaching consensus takes a genuine courage. Why? Because each of us must move away from our zone of comfort, and each of us must perhaps give up just a little of what we want. In the coming days, as you debate and discuss the subject of remuneration rates, I call on all of you, in the name of this historical union, to find the courage to choose the right path, not just for yourselves, but for the entire industry. I thank you very much for your attention.